beautiful Thursday. People are throwing back so many things. I don't know what you're throwing back, pictures, videos, but I think Ike has something to throw back today. I'm sure it's a music video. So this is Let's Talk Entertainment. It's another exciting edition. You should stick and stay because your girl Becky is here with all the stories. You don't want to miss this. Today we're starting with, you know, something on arts. We have an arts gallery, which is located at the Pedriasi Lodge, which is called Big Apple's Arts Gallery. They are putting together an exhibition with Larry Otto, legendary Larry Otto. Of course, we were talking to Larry Otto, and he's been sharing so many things on art, things that you need to know. You need to have an eye for art. Yes, really, yes. So let's take a listen to Larry Otto. Today on Let's Talk Entertainment, we are talking arts. I have taken you through so many arts, you know, related stories. Today, there's an art exhibition which is coming up. Yes, it's dubbed No Diabetes Art Exhibition with legendary Larry Otto. Of course, I'm here to speak to the legend himself. You know, when you talk about arts here in Ghana. Hello, sir.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Obviously, this is not your first exhibition, is it?
No, I've had several exhibitions, both locally and internationally. And I keep on having, including this one that's coming up. Diabetes have been touted around as one of the mysterious diseases that keeps on cropping up, you know, and these days you've been hearing a lot about it, and people need help, you know, where there's an occasion where we can all chip in and help to alleviate some of the problems those who have diabetes experience, then it's a worthy cause, and I'm always prepared to support such causes. I think diabetes issues have been on the news recently, including the one that we heard that issues concerning diversion of, you know, drugs meant for them. We don't always have to dwell on the negatives. I think positively we can come in our small ways, like I'm doing with my paintings, to support a worthy cause. And I think it will go a long way to help alleviate some of the problems diabetic patients have, yes. Well, a lot of people who collect me always ask me when I'll be showing my works locally, because most often in the course of the year, I'm scheduled for exhibitions outside. So this is a fine opportunity for those who have been starved of my show to have the opportunity to see what I do over the course of the year, and I expect them to come in their numbers to support the worthy cause, you know, and to have a look at what I'm doing. And so this is a unique one for the Ghanaians.
So where and when is it happening?
It's happening at the Holiday Inn Hotel in the Airport City. Okay. From the 30th of October to the 30th of November.
Of November. It's a whole 1 month thing. You don't have to miss out on it. Obviously, you have a whole month to come to the Holiday Inn to see Larry. Well, I like to call him Larry because, you know, Larry is like so short, and because Larry is the one behind the camera, I just want to say that you should come by. You have a whole month to come by the Holiday Inn to see Larry Otu's paintings, things that you haven't seen before. I'm sure you haven't seen any of them before. We have some, you know, right here in my background. Well, considering, you know, the number of people that will be coming, I'm sure a lot of people will be passing through, but a lot of people who know you and know you well, I mean, you're big, you're very big, I must say that. Will it be expensive for, you know, the normal Ghanaian? Maybe.
Not necessarily. I mean, they will be affordable.
Okay.
The thing about it is that come and see what I've been able to depict on the canvases. You know, if it suits your fancy, you can negotiate and it will be available. You are supporting the worthy cause, so it will be advisable to come prepared. Come with your friends at collectors, those who have an in thing for artists, how they produce their work. And I'm available for questions, and also you can see new things that I'm doing. I think it's an occasion to move away from the drudgery and the stressful nature of society sometimes, and come and feast your eyes on wonderful things and to refresh your whole being. Yeah.
For, you know, the many Ghanaians, not necessarily Ghanaians, but for the many people out there who don't appreciate art, who don't really have eyes for art, what can you tell them? What can you tell them to, you know, have them come on the 30th of October to the 30th of November holiday?
Yeah, there's always a first time for getting an experience. So those who don't really understand art, and with emphasis on painting, like I said earlier on, I'm available. You can come and have a look. Painting is a vocation or a pastime, or one could take it as a hobby, and coming to see it for the first time, or I mean, having experienced it before, also gives you an opportunity to refresh your mind, and also to get acquainted with the artist, his mind, and how he goes about his day-to-day activities, you know. And it's also an opportunity for young and up-and-coming artists, you know, students, and our traditionalists, because there will be a lot of paintings on our tradition. I try as much as possible to record history and also what we do as a country. And also there will be opportunity to have a look at music. I'm a music person. I don't play instruments, but
okay.
I like jazz, and I like to depict my music on canvas. It's a whole experience for art lovers, and please take your time and take your time off your day-to-day schedule and pass by Holiday Inn from the 30th to the 30th of November.
That will be interesting, you know. Having, you know, see, looking at music or in art, I can't imagine it, you know, trying to depict music whilst painting. That's interesting. What inspires you? You've mentioned a couple of things, history, music, but I just
I get intrigued by the musicians when they are playing their instruments. You know, it's just like at the market where you have your mothers or your those who sell their wares bringing things together. You attend an orchestra or you watch an orchestra on telly, and you see that everybody has a part to play. The saxophonist, the trumpet player, the drum, and even the conductor. You know, it's like a whole scenario of creativity, something that is being done to make others happy and to create an avenue for you to release your stress. You know, we need to cultivate the habit of enjoying music as a pastime, not only the hip-hop or the local this thing, but jazz and cool music, music that suits the soul and creates in you a refreshing atmosphere. Yeah.
Definitely, definitely interesting as well. Before I let you go, though, the people putting this together, which is Big Apples, what do you have to tell them?
Big Apple is big. Like the name suggests, Big Apple is here to stay. The organizers of Big Apple have a nice gallery up the Abri Mountains, and I think it's a place and a must-see place. They are doing their very best, and I think we need to help them, to encourage them to keep it up, because there are so many avenues our up-and-coming generation can look up to. And Big Apple has set up the pace. And they need a lot of support, they need a lot of encouragement. And like the name, we all have to bite big into the apple to make it juicy and helpful.
Away from that, let's talk about Majid Michelle. You know, Majid is now a preacher man. So, you know, I caught up with him yesterday and I asked him, so what are some of your challenges? What are some of the challenges that you face, you know, in these times? You know, you've changed from, you know, boom, an actor to a preacher man. It's very difficult for some people to, you know, come to accept that Majid is a changed man now. But what actually are your challenges, Majid?
The meat here brought it out at a point in time, but this thing has always been there. People have said, no, Majid, you cannot be born again. Who is going to play all those roles for us to watch? You know, we've had that a lot of times, and I haven't stopped acting. Acting is still the ministry, and that is what we're going to use as a platform to still hold the people down. So Majid is still acting. He hasn't left acting. He's still going to do it. So nothing has changed.
Are we going to be seeing you, you know, doing this like for life? As a point, sometimes people stop.
Go into all the world, preach my message until the day I return to the soil where I was made from, including you.
I am preaching the word.
Good. This, you see this? This is your battlefield. This is your office for the word. You don't need a church. Film, movies, that is my battlefield. I don't need a church.
Okay. All right, that was Majid Michelle for you. I hope you understand him. I hope that, you know, you will support Majid in his, you know, endeavor, everything that he wants to do. You just, you know, support him so that we can win souls for Christ. Let's move away from Majid and talk about Pascal Amanfo. You know, he is a music director and producer. Yes, he says that the only way the movie industry can come back on its feet is to, you know, have more cinemas here in Ghana.
Very practically, I like to say that there are a few challenges, and those challenges they go beyond just films not, quote unquote, selling or movies not doing better. They're very fundamental challenges in terms of structures that need to be put in place, and also it's a rather of a long term thing. So yeah, those challenges are there for now. But I still think that in the midst of the challenge, there's still ways to thrive, not just thrive, to flourish. So yes, I see the challenges, and in terms of we might need a lot more cinemas, because DVD is going extinct, and what you call it, internet platforms are all being pirated, and all kinds of download streams and all of that. So we might go back to the real practice of filmmaking, which is show movies in cinemas. And then if you think about just two cinemas, if I live in Winneba or I live off the Dodowa Road and you want me to come to West Hill Mall to see a movie, that's a big challenge. Why can't there be a cinema at a dental? Why can't there be a cinema at a Manfall? You know, so we need some kind of funding, you know, to widen up the enclave. Imagine someone coming from Tema, coming all the way to Accra Mall. Why would you do that? So we need a lot more cinemas, a bit more structures in terms of piracy.